is very simple. In today's day and age, when everything is available at the click of a mouse or possibly at the touch of a fingertip, you know, how do we regulate the entertainment industry? Now, it is just not restricted to film screenings. It is just not restricted to, you know, screenings of theaters that are happening or musical concerts that are being organized, over which also a lot of water has flown, and clearly netas have taken divergent viewpoint, maybe to appease their own vote banks. We're not going into that domain. While Sriram Kari says that the government must step in and really hard, stringent measures need to be adopted, but how do we regulate and ensure that we have no truck with Pakistan when it comes to the online and the virtual world as well, which is ruling the roost? Because hardly people are watching TV. Everyone you hear is on these platforms which are streaming for hours together, where there's a healthy mix, as they say, as some producers have said, of India and Pakistani artists.
Well, that's a very interesting point you have raised, Saurabh. We have seen a very classic debate going on the commercial interest versus the national interest. And I've normally seen that commercial interests have somehow managed to dilute the national interest in their own tactical and strategic move. Whether it's India-Pakistan, you might see World Cup happening in India and Pakistan playing in June in UK. So that is one of the possibilities, because one of the major sponsors is Nissan. And I'm sure they will be using all their entire lobby, because there's huge investment involved in World Cup and India-Pakistan being one of the very, very preferred, will attract a lot of eyeballs. But unfortunately, the problem with the IT sector is most of the servers are not within the jurisdiction of India. They are outside. Like, China can block it completely, but India does not have yet the power, though we call ourselves IT power. The servers are located outside jurisdiction of India. Yes. Even if you want to block it, you can't block it. So that's a technical glitch out here. But I think what government should do right now should step in and come out with some kind of a technological solution, so that we can block even the viewing Pakistanis on online. That will be also one of the biggest hit on the, like, on monetization concept, which YouTube flourishes. Pakistan will lose a lot of revenue in that process. I think
that's a great point. Babu, you were making a point. This is about internet governance. Now, is it really possible to regulate the internet, and how do we stop this? Because